All right, so we just got done in the third presentation talking about size sorting. And this is an extension of size sorting, but even more powerful in terms of what perhaps we're dealing with as a potential threat in a thunderstorm. And this is what's known as the ZDR Arc. And it's a signature to spot increasing low-level rotation potential. So if we consider our cell, now at least we're somewhat taking a view from above, whereas before we were sort of just looking off in the distance. Now we're sort of looking down on our cell. Here we can imagine our idealized reflectivity. Here are high values in the core of the downdraft area, kind of farther back in the storm where everything's falling out. Reflectivity values maybe 50, 60 dBZ. And let's imagine some storm relative wind vectors. And so down closer to the surface, winds out of the southeast, down or in the mid-levels, perhaps more winds from the south, or at least into the screen. And then from more of a left to right direction, we can imagine maybe a westerly wind as we get higher up. So we can just imagine this idealized version of our storm relative winds. So we're going to introduce two raindrops, a fascinating storm. It's produced all of two raindrops. And it, somehow, though, we're getting high reflectivity out of it. But we have a small drop and an idealized version of a large drop. So we're going to get these in motion. Our large drop is going to fall really fast. And so it doesn't have tons of time to be advected by this wind. So it falls out right here. Now let's see what happens with our small drop. It doesn't fall quite as fast relative to the larger drop, and so it has more time to be advected by the winds. So it gets pushed somewhere farther downstream, deeper into the storm. What does that tell us about what we should expect with ZDR? So let's introduce our idealized ZDR. There are values for reference. If our bigger drops are all falling here on this flank and our smaller drops are all getting pushed farther into the storm, we get high ZDR right here on the edge of that higher reflectivity. And it forms somewhat of an arc shape. This is the ZDR arc. And you can see values 3, 4 plus dB. Whereas as we start to get into these smaller drops advected farther downstream, we get lower ZDR. So we're going to introduce an idealized hodograph here. And we can imagine the storm direction is off to the northeast. There's an X for it. And let's drop all of our vectors down to the hodograph. Whoa. Check that out. As we move all of them down, we see they're representing a pretty good swept out area on our hodograph, which indicates our storm relative helicity. And as you know, or as you're learning through class right now, the more storm relative helicity you have, the better potential you have for rotation in the storm, especially as you get more and more low-level storm relative helicity. That can enhance or at least increase the potential for low-level rotation in a storm. And so if you see the ZDR arc signature, you can tie it back, as we just did. The magnitude and the curvature of the ZDR arc can reveal greater potential for low-level rotation through that size sorting ability. And so it's a pretty cool signature to see in terms of what you start to learn about what the storm is doing. So we're going to use an example here. This is, I don't know if any of you recall, but from Dallas-Fort Worth, just south of Dallas County, the day after Christmas, not this past year, but the year before in 2015 it would have been, where we had multiple tornadoes across the DFW Metroplex. So on the left is reflectivity, on the right is velocity. We can see already a nice supercell type structure. We'll move it across to see it relative to velocity. We can see our outbound winds here on the southern flank of our cell, on the rear flank of it. And then our inbound winds, our radar is kind of located off to the north and west. So we have our nice area of inflow and then our wind wrapping around the side of this supercell for reference. Now we're going to look at ZDR and we're going to leave our one wind vector, if you will, not so much a vector, but just this wind direction that we had in velocity. And you'll notice something, this high area of differential reflectivity, closer to 3, 4 dB, even higher. That's the ZDR arc that's appearing on the forward flank reflectivity gradient, that inflow region right here on the edge of reflectivity as we overlay it. That's the ZDR arc. Now, of course, as we did previously in the other examples, we want to use correlation coefficient to ensure we can trust the data. And we have a nice high correlation coefficient close to 1, so we're good to go on that high ZDR. We can trust it. We're going to move forward in time now, and now really look at it. What appears to be our ZDR arc has developed even further. We see a nice high area of ZDR, if you match it up, is right on our forward flank reflectivity gradient. So we have that enhanced size sorting from that strong storm relative veering profile. So we can expect that there's probably better low-level storm relative helicity here. We switch to velocity, and we start to see even more development in terms of stronger inbound. So we would expect more of that size sorting with stronger inbounds. And we also see somewhat in the way of stronger outbounds, again, with our radar up to the northwest. So there's definitely this increasing rotation that we witness here, or at least in organizing a supercell thunderstorm at low levels. There are outbound winds, and if we move forward in time even further, we start to see right here what looks like potentially a little velocity couplet. Our inbound still going strong, and we see our hook has matured even more so. So clearly our supercell has developed even further. And right around this time, a tornado did develop in the northern part of Ellis County, just south of Dallas County, which is located up here. If we look at ZDR too, we really notice that ZDR arc has strengthened even further, and it actually curves all the way around the edge of the inflow region here. So as we see that stronger and stronger inflow, that stronger storm relative flow, and it's veering with height, we get that curvature developing in the ZDR arc. Those values increase all due to that size sorting of those different size drops. And that reveals, just through ZDR and comparing it to reflectivity and checking it with correlation coefficient, how the low-level storm scale environment's changing. And that's really cool that we can pick that out of the storm microphysics just through our radar data. So ZDR arcs, what do they reveal? It's a potential for increasing low-level rotation. I will stress, it doesn't explicitly predict tornado genesis. We can't say, oh, I have a strong ZDR arc here, we're going to get a tornado to form. It's just telling us something about our low-level and even mid-level storm relative felicity. So it can reveal a potential, an increasing potential, for rotation. We want to look for high ZDR in an area of modest, relatively modest reflectivity along that inflow gradient, where we go from very little reflectivity and then increase rapidly as we start to go deeper into the storm cell. But we also want to make sure, as we mentioned before, that correlation coefficient is high enough, those values 0.8, 0.9, especially above 0.9 to really trust it, that we trust it enough to ensure that we're dealing with meteorological scatters, things like raindrops. And with that, we'll wrap up the session on ZDR arcs.